Hello everyone and welcome back to English Ambassador. So today we have for you a video called What It Means to Be White by a little BBC YouTube channel called BBC Stories that has 300k subscribers and is only capable of racking up 7,000 views. So I imagine in this video we'll have a bunch of white people talking about what it's like being them, considering this is about what it means to be white. So we'll see, won't we? All right, let's have a go.
So my name's Jack Waters. I go by the name of J0117 from Bristol. I'm a grime artist. So since getting into this position of influence from social media and music, I've sort of tried looking at things that may not be talked about in modern day so much. For example, race, class, gentrification.
Are you seriously trying to tell me that in today's society we do not talk about race, class, gender, gentrification? Do you really think we don't talk about that? That's like literally all everybody's talking about. It's all over everywhere. It's feminist man this, black oppression this, for all the bloody time. You really think that that's not what we're talking about? Really, you really think that it's not possible to talk about that? I tell you what it isn't possible to talk about is race in any way regards to being white and actually quite enjoying the experience. We have to hate the fucking experience, otherwise we can just shut up and listen to the coloured person. Sorry, you can't say coloured person, the black person, the person of colour, the person who has different colour skin to mine, whatever the fuck.
I've been hearing a lot of talk about white fragility, white privilege, white supremacy, and people's talking about whiteness as a whole.
So you want to engage, the whole idea of this video in the first 20 seconds is that you want to engage with subjects that aren't talked about, like race. And then you proceed to say that you've heard a lot of talk about race. Not a very bright spark, are you? In the same fucking sentence, you say that we can't talk about race, and then everybody's talking about race. Like, fucking hell, man.
I've been seeing blog posts, Instagram challenges, Fiat 500 Twitter, so it's just got me a little bit curious, so I'm gonna go and find out a bit more about it.
Right, but from a white person? The writer. Conversation with the writer, the only one that ever shall exist.
Hello, good to meet you.
Hi Jay, it's really nice to meet you too. So my name is Layla Saad.
So now a black person is going to tell me what it's like to be white, is it? Right, let's hear this. Let's go for it, shall we?
I'm a writer and a speaker and a teacher on issues of anti-racism and identity. And in the summer of 2018, I decided to run a 28-day challenge under the hashtag Me and White Supremacy. It was using this process of reflective journaling.
What is reflective journalism? Is that when you use your brain and you think? Are you not supposed to do that in all kinds of journalism? Or is it like a mirror, reflective mirror? What does it even mean? What does it even mean?
And so what I was asking was a simple formula of a question. What have you learned about you and a particular aspect of white supremacy? And so we kicked off with day one, looking at white privilege. And it just was this incredible, it was like lighting a fire. It went viral.
So what's your sort of definition?
So the first thing we're going to talk about in what it's like to be a white person is white supremacy and white privilege. Right. So that's all it involves. The only thing that it involves is me going around oppressing people and me going around having privilege based on the color of my skin. Right.
So white supremacy.
Yeah. So I think the first thing I think people need to understand is that white supremacy is not about, it's not a personal thing. If you are white or if you are given the privilege of being seen as white.
If we are given the privilege of being seen as white. So what you're saying is, is that that has absolutely nothing to do with me. So I'm white, I'm born white, I can't help that. But because someone sees it as a privilege for me being white, it's my problem because of their brains. Like, how are we using our brains here? What happens in your brain, dear woman, is my problem. It's my fault. Right, I get you.
You will be treated as if you are superior to those who are black and brown and indigenous.
Because they see us as superior, whether we want to or not. So it's like, hey, look, I don't want to be superior. I don't feel superior. I don't see myself as superior to you. Hey, dude, shut up. I see you as superior, therefore you are superior. You have white privilege. Shut the fuck up and listen to me. What? What? So you, Mrs. Black Woman, have an inferiority complex in regards to the color of your skin. And I'm just going to say this. You're not the blackest of black women I've ever seen. So there's got to be some whiteness in there. And so are you struggling with that part of your background? Are you going to completely ignore that part of your background? We just black. No, there's no white in there at all. None. Zero. Right. So you see yourself as inferior. And because you have an inferiority complex in regard to the color of your skin and you see white skin as a privilege, you see white skin as a privilege. Therefore, I have to check mine. Because, like, what the fuck? This makes no sense. You're talking gibberish. You're talking complete and utter gibberish.
Which comes from, you know, colonialism, which comes from the slave trade.
Oh, the slave trade and colonialism and blah, 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 blah. Okay, so this, we are talking in Britain right now. And I do believe that Britain ended the slave trade and went to immeasurable lengths to actually stop the slave trade all around the world. Yes, we participated in it for a while, and then we thought, hang on a minute, this isn't very nice. Let's stop this, shall we? And no person alive today is a slave. And, or, well, actually they are, but not in white countries. But, no, you're not a slave. I didn't own slaves. The vast majority of my ancestors didn't own slaves. It's only about 3% of Americans that own slaves, the really rich ones. The rest of us were all poor as fuck. Everybody's been poor as fuck for the entire fucking time of human existence. But now, because you have an inferiority complex in regards to your own skin color, you have to... Is that why you eat so many donuts and you've got like 3 chins? I'm not going to go there. Right, so, yeah, slave trade, colonialism, let's just play bingo here, shall we? White supremacy, skinhead, Nazi, right, yeah, we gotcha.
I know that the word white supremacy is often hard for many people to have to sort of look at. I'm not a white supremacist. That's those people who are, you know, the skinheads or the Nazis or the ones who, you know, use the racial slurs. But again, white supremacy is not something you can choose to opt in and opt out of.
Yeah, so what do you call this? Like, so I can't escape whatever it is that your worldview is. That's called you, woman, being a racist. You're a racist because you see me based on an immutable characteristic as being a certain way. That is a definition of racism. Judging someone by the color of their skin rather than the content of their character. You are a racist.
Because the whole foundation is set on this idea that white is superior.
No, it's not.
So, Jay,
No, it's not. That's not what it's set on. That's not what I believe it's set on. And if I don't believe that that's what it's set on, then it can't be the entire bloody foundation, is it? Because the foundation is made up of loads of individuals. This guy sitting here doesn't believe that that's what it's set up on. My my family don't believe that that's what it's set up on. Most of my friends don't believe that that's what it's set up on. You're not just talking complete and utter bullshit.
I was really curious to hear about what it's been like for you, especially as a white man in an industry that is, you know, music scene that is very black.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I really love that kind of music. It's really my type of music.
And I feel, I'm aware that with grime music and it being a voice of the unheard, I sort of see it as a voice of the streets. I'm in a position now of influence. I need to be very conscious of sort of what I write about, what I do, what I put on social media. I still pay homage and love to the history and of the music, which I try to do as much as possible. It is an art form, and it has to also,
well, only just, mate, only just
relate to me and be a part of me.
Yeah, I think that
she didn't care. That, yeah, okay, stop talking now, it's my turn.
The gray area that I think more of us, especially people who hold white privilege, need to be comfortable.
She just had to put it in there, like, especially people that hold white privilege, that means you, white boy,
being in. It's not about you either are racist or not racist, you either are a good person or you're a bad person, you either are culturally appropriating or you're not culturally appropriating.
So are you trying to in some sly way say that this white man is culturally appropriating because he likes to sing grime music because grime music is mostly black? Is that what you're saying? Are you culturally appropriating there with your headphones on in a nice apartment rather than a mud hut?
Having more of the conversation of the complex layers of it, that we're all on this journey.
What complex layers?
Trying to figure it out so that we can create a better world.
See, like, this just, it's just words. It's just fucking words. What complex layers are you talking about? Are you just saying that they're complex words, that there are complex layers so that you sound like you know what you're talking about, but what are the complex layers of it? Because to me, it seems pretty obvious that you're the one with the problem. Because you're the one that sees it that way. So maybe you need to change the way you see it so that you stop putting me on a fucking pedestal so that I can just go about my life without you thinking I'm superior to you. Because I'm not. Just another fucking human being. Except for I'm using common sense and I'm using my eyes and you're not. You're using your stupid ideology that says colonialism bad, slavery, yada, yada, yada. That's all you've got in your head. It's like, what, brilliant. Yeah, well, you know, white privilege. Yeah. I couldn't get a job the other day, white privilege, because, you know, it was like slavery. Like, fucking, yeah, it's like intersectional Tourette is what they got. Fucking hell.
Yeah, that makes sense. Thank you.
No, it doesn't, you stupid dumb fuck. It doesn't make sense at all. There was no sense spoken. What are you talking about, you idiot? He's like, yeah, that makes sense.
Very much.
Thank you.
Conversation with the friend. Ooh.
So this is my mate MZ, somebody I do music with. That's my time, because the mic and So when I invited you down to have this conversation about whiteness, what did you initially think?
It depends on how you talk about it, to be honest. Because a lot of conversations are just coming to dead ends. Well, we're this colour and we feel like this. And you're that colour and you feel like this.
Maybe the way that I feel has got nothing to do with my colour, and you know? Maybe, just maybe. You know, maybe I like strawberries. So how does that relate? Like, I feel nice when I eat a strawberry. Do I feel nice when I eat a strawberry because I'm white? Do all white people feel the same way about strawberries? Don't know, I haven't asked. No, actually, I do know that, they don't. My sister hates strawberries. So there, two white people. Unless she's like secretly black and I didn't realise. Two white people don't feel the same way about strawberries. How did that happen? Who knows? Maybe everybody's different.
Like, I would say the dangers of having this conversation, when you start to understand how disconnected you are and if they even want to make the connection, because it will affect their lifestyle.
Why are you assuming that all the people that want to talk about this are disconnected? Before it even start, Then you have to talk to them first before you realise whether they are connected or disconnected, and disconnected or connected to what? It's like, connected to the way that you see it, because otherwise we're disconnected. If we don't see it the way you see it, then we're totally disconnected, obviously. Just obviously.
We'll take away from that because they have more and we have less.
Who's they? Who's they? Are you talking about white people when you say they? What about the homeless white guy? Has he got more? What about the, I don't know, the bin man? Does the bin man have more? What, who's got, they got more, you got less, like what the fuck? I've got less hair than you. What are we talking about? Less of what? More of what? What the fuck is this?
So yeah, it's common knowledge that there's a thing called Black Twitter, which is the black
community. I didn't know that. I thought it was just called Twitter.
Which is at times very strong. You know, if somebody slips up in the white community, it's cancel o'clock. It is. It's
game over. So so if you say the wrong thing, then you get mobbed, and then the white person that got mobbed and gets cancelled gets a shit off of Twitter, and therefore they have less Twitter. So if the gauge of who has more and who has less is Twitter, then the person mobbed for being a so-called racist, according to you, he then has less Twitter than the black guys on Twitter. So there's another hole in your theory there, man. You know, I'm just saying.
Over for the, some might think, oh, well, can't we have a white Twitter?
Fucking hell.
My short and blunt answer would be, you can't have a white Twitter because you have everything else. I feel this could be an example of...
Stop ringing. In the middle of a fucking video. Pick the phone up. Stop. Finally.
Disconnect.
Jesus.
If a white person may go on Twitter, they'll go onto black Twitter, and then they'll see some sort of joke about a Fiat, you know, the whole Fiat 500 gang, innit? Like, ditzy white girl stereotype, innit? Kind of thing, like, they drive a Fiat 500.
Oh, so they're being racist against white girls, and that's fine, right, I guess?
They'd watch Love Island 24/7.
Cheeky Nando's.
Stereotypes.
Cheeky Nando's, partying in photos, and... Yeah.
Because that then begs the
it's the same thing. It's the same thing as it's the same thing as stereotyping me as being a gang member, innit? The difference between the stereotypes, like you can stereotype.
Now he's going to proceed to tell us how them stereotyping us, or no, them, him and his friends, or his black Twitter guys stereotyping the white girls, isn't as bad as stereotyping him as a gang member, is because, take it away.
Type of a girl being 500 Twitter, but that's a harmless stereotype. And it's stereotype me, black boy, gangster, in a gang, does this, does that. There's so much more, it's so much more harmful.
Is it? How? If you're not a gang member, then who the fuck cares? Maybe you should stop dressing like a gang member for a start. Maybe you should stop talking like a gang member. Who knows? Maybe that's got something to do with the stereotype. Maybe it's got nothing to do with the colour of your skin. Maybe it's got a little bit to do with the way that you present yourself and the way that you talk. Maybe, just a little bit. Just a little bit.
These are things that are actually damaging the community, and it can derail your whole life on the other side of the spectrum. So,
what can? Getting involved in a gang? Sure, but I don't think that the stereotype can derail your life, because the stereotype is just like, it's nothing. There's nothing there. So, you know, maybe don't associate with the gang types, and tell your friends not to associate with the gang types. Tell your children not to associate with the gang types. Don't tell your children that everybody's a racist and is out to get you. Make them feel confident in the society that they live in. And, you know, stop thinking everyone's a racist, and maybe, it might, you know, be a little bit less harmful. But, you know.
And it all stems from a place of negativity, really.
Yeah, and ridiculous negativity.
Look at his face. That is such a fake face. You can tell it's a fake face because, you know, people put their outer lip out first like that when they're trying to act serious. I don't know why they do that, but watch it. You know, when they're trying to act serious, but they're fake, you can see it. They're like going, they put their face down like this. Like, and then I kind of like that is a fake face. That's you. That's you. That's what you're doing right now. That is a fake face of caring. When you really care, you don't make this face.
Because it doesn't matter. It doesn't. What's the difference? The difference between me and you is my hair's thicker, your eyes are lighter, you burn easier.
Yeah.
That's it.
No, it's not. There's plenty more different. For one of you is sitting on the left and the other one's sitting on the right. Also, you don't have the same parents, you didn't have the same upbringing, you don't have the same ideas. You don't like the same type of women. You probably don't like the same type of food. There's probably some things that you prefer, some things that he prefer. Maybe he likes brown sauce, maybe you like ketchup. Who the hell knows? Maybe you like mayonnaise. Maybe there's a little bit of, you know, weird shit going on there. What do you like in bed? Maybe he's gay, maybe you're straight. Who knows? I'm sure that there is a lot of things that are different between you other than those skin traits. You know, so maybe if you stop only seeing skin, you might, you know, get a little bit of more in-depth view of the world.
Appreciate that. Love always, man.
Oh yeah, love always, man. Fucking hell. Conversation with the group. Fucking hell.
I will start. I think whiteness means the norm. Whiteness means majority.
No, it doesn't. If you go to the Congo, whiteness doesn't mean majority. If you go to China, whiteness don't mean majority. If you go to Brazil, they're Hispanic. Whiteness don't mean majority. If you go to Japan, etc., 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 woman. Look at her face as well. It's like, she doesn't even believe what she's saying. That face is not a face of being convinced with what you're saying. You don't believe what you're saying, woman. Look at that face. Can you see the face? Look at the face. See the face. The face. The face. It means majority, but it don't know, does it? Because I realise that from where I am from, or at least half of my ancestors are from, the majority ain't white. So it doesn't mean norm either, does it? Because we're actually a global minority, you dumb fucks.
Yeah, we get educated on white people oppressing other races and white people having slaves and going over and not doing very positive things.
So he's admitting that here we get educated that white people are just trash. And everything that we've ever done and everything that our ancestors ever built was all bad. Everything. Absolutely everything. There was nothing good to come out of the empire. Zero. Zilch. Nothing. Nothing at all. No roads, no buildings, no nothing. No farming. Nah. None of that. Nothing. Zilch. Everything that we do is negative things.
In history, so that's why I feel like we do get told a history of whiteness. But it's not one to be proud of or shout from the rooftops.
That's really interesting, actually, because I've...
Oh, yeah. You just said some really negative stuff and some really bad about stuff about white people. As I said, it's really interesting that you was going to say that. Imagine, it's like, hey, no, dude, hang on a minute. You're okay. You didn't do anything wrong. You can be proud of yourself. Don't worry about that. Your ancestors built this country. Without the help of that many slaves, you know. Most of the buildings that are built today weren't built by slaves. So, you know, you can be proud of that. You know, it's a nice country. You're a nice person. You're white. You can be proud of that. Yeah. No. That's really interesting what you said when you were saying all that negative shit. It's really interesting that you should say that. Because that was what I was thinking exactly.
I was assuming that history is still not really accurate, and even what we are taught isn't what it is. But yeah, that's really interesting for you to say that.
I'm from America.
Yeah, well, you know, there is debates on how close to the mark history is. It isn't, it is what it is. know what it is, and it's not possible that every single thing that led us to this point in time, which is the best time to be alive for anybody, the easiest time to be alive. Everybody's got food. Everybody, I mean, that's fucking awesome, right? There's no way that only negative things got us here. Just use your brain.
America. My mum came to England with no white privilege. She worked as a maid for rent. She works 9 to 5, 6 days a week, and she's done that for the past 12 years.
White privilege doesn't necessarily have to be like financial.
So it's like, there's no way out of it. This guy's mum has toiled her ass off to give him a life, and then he's like, well, it's not always about financial things. So what exactly privilege has a homeless man got because he's white? Like, seriously, like, what the fuck? You just, what the fuck?
At the same time,
look at him sitting there.
Sometimes
look.
It's hard for people to take
look at his face.
To swallow that word, privilege.
Yeah. It's really hard for him to fucking swallow him. Look at him there, looking into the fucking abyss. He's just switched completely off from everything that these people are saying, because they're just like, oh, your story don't count, mate, because you're telling the wrong story. So it doesn't matter that you don't fit the pattern. It don't matter that you don't fit the pattern. We don't care about you because, you know, you shut up because you're hurting our story here. We wanted to paint a story where all white people are privileged and all white people are fucking bastards. But your mum, she was really hardworking, so you just shut the fuck up and let us tell you you're a racist, please.
If they are somebody that grew up with nothing.
Yeah, because if they grew up with nothing, they didn't have any fucking privilege and they built their privilege. Yeah, which is what our parents did for us, you know.
I think maybe there are degrees, I don't know whether you agree, there are degrees of white privilege.
I think it's
Boris
intersectional.
Johnson white privilege.
Oh, you think it's intersectional? Could you mind explaining what that word means, or are you just going to throw it in there? Whee!
Then I am.
So it depends on race, class, it depends on many things, but...
So it's impossible to define because it depends on too much shit? Okay, I get
it. It is a lot. It's a lot, like, even for...
So then he was going to say something, and then you cut him off. You, what's that, female privilege?
Me as a black woman.
Yes, but you're not just a black woman, are you? You're mixed race. Why are you erasing that half of you? Like, you're not a black woman, you're mixed race. That means there's white in there as well. So, you know.
Of all of my life experience, and I've worked at a university developing a race equality initiative, I'm still confused and like, don't even know where to start. And like, with.
So, at university, you studied race and equality and shit, and you still don't know what the fuck you're talking about. That is not something you should be announcing or proud of. Like, if you went to university to study this shit, you should come out with a little bit of knowledge that you could explain to us, you know, but that... But you didn't. You didn't learn anything in university, and you're admitting it now that university was a complete fucking waste of time.
White British identity, I'll answer the question. I guess a lot of white people hold on to like the empire and, you know, the royals, and I guess...
Don't give a shit about the royals. British Empire weren't that bad.
That's quite a big, I don't know, part of your identity or... Your culture?
I would. Some people, me personally,
I'd say that's not my
identity.
No.
But it's always...
And that's the interesting thing is that I would have spent a long time talking about diversity,
the size of it.
Thinking about representation, but never thought about, well, hang on a minute, I am actually white. What does that mean? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's quite weird, really,
it's very
when you think
weird.
About it.
Is it, though? You think you just got some big... Bush moment there, like, what are you even talking about, man? What are you even talking about? What is weird when you think about it? It's weird that someone realizes, oh, they're white. What about me with representatives? What the fuck?
Yeah. And with like this whole, like, when you say you just never thought about being white, it's just crazy.
Yeah.
We have to think about being our skin color every single day.
Yeah.
No, you don't. You choose to do that. You don't have to think about your skin colour every single day. You don't have to give a fuck about it.
Just always.
Well,
all
to
the
an
time.
Extent, like you say it like that, but like, so I lived in a cultured area. Like, I used to get stick for being the only white kiddy all day long. And you have the.
Yeah, I bet. So she knows. She knows that it goes both ways. But she's just pretending like it don't. And then she's crossing her arms like this. Because you're not agreeing with me. You don't agree with me. Oh, fucking hell. This guy's on to us. He knows it's all bullshit. Fucking hell. Blah, 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 blah. And this guy's pretending like, yes. This guy, yeah. Yes, yes. Very interesting. It's very interesting when you think about it. Yes.
These conversations with people years after a situation happened, you say, why did you do that to me? And it's like, because I wasn't informed that, like, I was informed wrong. And I can now go have a drink with these guys. Like, it's a very weird topic.
It is.
Well, I don't...
It's like they're not going anywhere with this. This is the most shallow, worthless, pointless conversation I've ever heard. Nothing interesting has been said so far.
I don't know. I mean, I know we're having the conversation about whiteness, but I don't really know what the outcome of, obviously...
Yeah, you haven't actually said anything. That's why you don't know what the outcome of this conversation is.
It allows us to say...
All you've done is agree with everything she said and gone, well, you know, white privilege, something.
Oh, well, I agree, and or that.
I suppose...
Where did they find this guy, man?
Awareness of white privilege, the system, institutions...
All the institutional systems of systems.
Which we operate, and then maybe not fall in for some of the manipulative messages which come from far-right groups.
They had to fucking get it in there, didn't they? What far-right groups? What manipulative messages? What exactly is far-right to you? People that go, no, I refuse to be classed as a racist just on the basis of my skin. I like this country. I love this country. I fucking love being white. Whatever the fuck that means, how could I not love it? Because if I don't love it, I fucking hate myself. But I don't. I don't. I really don't. And I'm not superior to you. No. You're the one who wants to make me superior. I refuse to be superior, woman. I refuse to be superior to you, even though you want me to. I refuse it. I fucking refuse it.
I can't be bothered to kind of always talk about, you know, oh, this happened today, someone touched my hair.
Yeah,
because it's just not what happens.
There's more important
things
in life. Maybe
one day we won't have to deal with it. Someone will come, step in and say, hold on a minute, that's not right.
I feel, me personally, I probably subconsciously sort of just try and
I don't think most people are like that. I really don't. I think you're all bullshitting. You're bullshitting.
See, that can turn to that whole I'm not proud to be white to just
I don't even talk about it. Like, and that kind of, oh, you know, I'm not racist.
That's
not helpful.
So yeah.
So it's not about.
So what if saying I'm not a racist? How's like? So what? We're supposed to do everything for you? We're supposed to fight your. Is this person is going? No, look, I'm not getting involved. I'm not a racist. Like, is she supposed to fight all your battles for you? Is that it? Can't you fight your own battles? Are you admitting that you need the white man to fight your battles for you? Is that what you're saying? That is what you're saying. It's not what you want to be saying, but it is what you're saying, isn't it?
It's not about being right on, is it?
No, absolutely not. Yeah. Listening or trying to understand.
Just listening or trying to understand. No speaking. Just listening. You can't speak. They can't try and understand us. Coming here. She's probably born here, but like you're telling people that we're horrible people, and people aren't responding in a good way to that. And you're surprised.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we got into it, didn't we?
Well, fucking done, BBC.
So my name's Jack Waters.
Yeah, we know Mr. Jack Waters. Well, this is what your BBC contributions are paying for. I'm satisfied. I'm most certainly satisfied. Are you satisfied? Right, well, that's about it from me. If you enjoyed this tripe, subscribe. Thanks. If you lasted it this long, please post a comment and tell me that you watched it all the way through, because I am fucking impressed. Okay, subscribe and shit. Goodbye. Take care of yourself. Blah, blah, blah.